They're just taking rounds to the back of the head, not even not even flinching. Hey guys, I'm Tyler with Air from Denomer, and today we have Matt Meng here with us. He's on our R&D team. He's been with us for about 4 years. As you guys know, I started the company, founded it. I've been designing armor and manufacturing plate carriers for about 7 years. Together, we have quite a bit of experience designing products, armor solutions, and that sort of thing. What we're doing today is going to watch some clips of videos and compare them to how armor performs in movies in relation to how it performs in real life. Today we're going to be starting with the ending of John Wick 3, where they storm the Continental. If you have not seen John Wick 3, probably a good idea to stop the video here, unless you are into spoilers. So there's a lot to unpack in the start of them storming John Wick in the Continental. Each guy took about 8 rounds, and the only way he finished them looked like pinning them to the ground, holding their head up, and taking a shot in the neck, meaning implying that they had face armor, helmet armor, and full body armor. Not to mention, it looks like he's using a dressed up Glock, one of the Terran Tactical 9mm Glocks, it looks like. So a couple things, with the amount of rounds each of those guys took, it's relatively easy to stop a bullet in terms of body armor. What's hard, especially when it comes to pistol rounds, what's hard to accomplish is mitigating the trauma that transfers through the armor to your body, which is generally going to be measured in something called back face deformation. So when you design an armor, you have to keep that in mind. It's not just about stopping the round, it's about stopping the round and protecting the wearer behind the body armor. In this example, they do that really well, so people can take 8 rounds and still move and be pretty functional afterwards. To do that in a lightweight, mobile, thin profile is going to be extremely difficult with materials that are available today, especially with multi-hit.
Yeah. And one of the things with the helmets is it's going to start to cave in after the first round, and multiple hits, it's just going to weaken and weaken, and eventually they're just going to get knocked out, or the round's going to penetrate through and kill them anyways without having to pin them to the ground and shoot them.
They're just taking rounds to the back of the head, not even not even flinching.
Yeah, these helmets, unless they're thick steel helmets, there's going to be energy transfer, and they're not just going to be able to just like flinch and walk it off.
We have a video up shooting an Aramid helmet shell with a 44 Magnum. I'd recommend you take a look at that video to show you what happens to a helmet that is 3A pistol rated, and then watch the presentation in John Wick and how they perform while wearing the helmet in staying seemingly unfazed, even though they're taking a couple rounds to the back of the head and the back in general with zero concern. Granted, we're still in the pistol phase of this, so let's keep it going. And still running a 9mm rifle.
That was a mistake.
I would step out of 9mm for this one.
So when I first saw this movie in theaters, working on some soft armor here, they pull out the 9mm major round and they're like, this is what we're gonna use, and I lean over to my girlfriend and I was like, the stuff I'm working on is gonna stop that. So the whole lead into that scene, I was like, I already know how this is gonna go just from my knowledge background on body armor. I knew he was gonna have a hard time shooting people and actually putting them down.
12-gauge steel slugs, armor piercing.
So they're grabbing some bigger guns and he goes to a 12-gauge. Which I know Matt has some comments on grabbing a 12-gauge for trying to get through armor.
I'm just seeing all these other guns that are rifles that would work much better at getting through the armor than a 12-gauge. 12-gauge is obviously just going to increase the energy transfer. It's not really going to penetrate through the armor, even through soft armor, but soft armor is still going to crush your chest if you get shot right here.
So a 12-gauge is really going to be meant for mass. A 12-gauge slug has a large amount of mass, and you can do a lot with that load. You can make them barrier-penetrating loads. They can go through shrubbery, car doors, that sort of thing. You can make them explosive rounds and incendiary rounds, and you can do a lot of stuff with 12-gauge. What it's not particularly good at in most cases, in most loads that you can buy regularly, is going to be penetrating armor, because it is such a heavy mass. There's a lot of mass to the round, and the more mass you have, generally speaking, the less effective it is at getting through most personnel armor systems. So short of like We're talking firearms you can carry, right? When you step up to a certain point, armor doesn't, it becomes irrelevant and you move into vehicles. But a 12 gauge, after experiencing that, coming from a 9mm, 12 gauge would probably not be the recommended choice. I'd probably move pretty quickly to some kind of AR-15 or something, something that's gonna get through armor depending on your round.
So I'm seeing a lot of headshots on the helmets, and I think that would kill somebody, even though it's probably not gonna penetrate. It's just gonna basically collapse the helmet in on the person's head, and just so much trauma to the head, and they're done.
And in this one, they're actually showing the blood splatter, so I think they're implying it's penetrating, but I'm with you. Any 12 gauge round is gonna just kill through deformation and energy transfer. It's not gonna penetrate a 12 gauge, for example, won't penetrate 3A soft armor or any 3A pistol rated armor. And it most certainly isn't gonna go through any rifle armor, short of a very special 12 gauge load, like some odd hand load, not something you're gonna buy or that's in production generally. Again, it's gonna be barrier penetration, it's gonna be incendiary, it's gonna be some kind of unique crowd control load or like a hunting slug, because again, you're using a 12 gauge to get mass or patterns, not so much to defeat body armor. An underwater body armor test may be an interesting next step. We'll see if we can set that up. That'd be interesting. If you would like us to try and see if armor will stop around underwater, let us know. We'll see if we can get that video made. Please give me an excuse to do that. Did you just kill that guy with a sword from the back with the armor on?
Yeah, I don't know exactly how he stabbed
that. Yeah, I'm not sure. So they have extreme handgun and rifle rated body armor. But it does not stop edged weapons, which is interesting. The table soldier guys, obviously completely unfazed by energy transfer. So it's not irrelevant. It's not something that they're concerned about in John Wick. Obviously they pick the rounds they do and they give them the armor systems they do for the choreography, with a very minimal display of real life capabilities of armor. Because if we can make a helmet like that, we would offer you guys a helmet like that. Absolutely, no question. So right now, not a reality. But we'll keep working on it. Matt's gonna not sleep till he gets you guys John Wick level armor. But if you guys have other clips or other things you want us to watch and give you guys our opinion on, feel free to let us know. If you want to see something tested that you see, that you're unsure how it works, let us know. We're happy to do that, and we'll see what kind of content we can get out for you guys.